should mean. Okay, this is Constantine. Unfortunately, he hurt his nose a while back and then developed a resistant infection. It didn't really respond to antibiotics. So what we do when this happens is we sedate him and open it up with a couple of incisions and then clean it out and pack with silvadine. And then every week after, we reopen the same incisions, which doesn't require sedation, and just clean it out. So that's what we're doing. Just every week with him, he's actually amazingly well behaved for it. It's not reasonable to sedate somebody every single week, so we do it awake. These are just the old incisions. We basically just don't let them heal. You can see there's silvadine in there. Oh, white Kimmy, look! Excellent, good job. So we open it with a pick. And then we're going to put a little bit of saline in there. We actually use feeding. This is a feeding needle, like for birds, basically. Works great for flushing abscesses. I'm just going to put a little bit in there. This is kind of a big one, but... door so we can hear better. This is a curette. So you can see this pocket goes all the way across. So I'm just loosening the crud that's in there is all this curette does. So it's not stuck to the inside of the pocket. I'm joking, we call them nose pickers. He's kind of an active boa, so he does tend to move around a lot while we do this. Which is okay. And that's kind of half silvadine, half pus coming out. Let me know if you need help, Kimmy.
Yeah, we do.
This is looking much better, like a lot of that is silvadine. Not a sterile procedure, so we don't bother with gloves and all that business. Cleaning out an abscess is never going to be sterile. Unless it's a sterile abscess, which is actually quite rare. It's happened, but... on your neck! What the heck, bud? He says, I don't know what to do to get Tammy to move. Move my tray. Hey, you. This side has a lot more yellow to it, which means it's still infection more so than silvadine. basically all it does is let his body work on the infection, and we just help clean out the after effects of his body working on it. So that his can keep body can keep working on it. It's really all this is. He is on antibiotics, but that hasn't really helped in the past. Well, yeah. Thank you. Hi, buddy. I'm just feeling for just normal anatomy underneath, so I can feel his maxillary bone under there, which means there isn't a bunch of crud still between the skin and normal anatomy. I think there's a piece right here, though, so. Where I keep thinking that, yep, that's like what I was feeling. That feels longer. Oh, this all feels normal to me now. Which means we'll flush it one last time and then put something in. All good. I'm going to kind of plug the holes and smush it around so that it kind of fills any nooks and crannies in there. He's looking around, following my fingers with his eyes. Alright, and then we'll give him his meds and we're done. We're finally getting through all these random needles that don't fit in the box. Yep, I like my tray. That's cool. That was Rimadyl, so anti-inflammatory and pain, because injection's still frozen. The antibiotic is frozen, so we gotta wait for